man, no festival. Anyway, good morning everyone and welcome to another chapter of the Quidditch storyline. This is literally the worst update for today. But on the bright side, we also have a creature side quest. I will do that after this, after the Quidditch quest. Guys, today is 11th September. Today is my birthday. And I have turned the lovely age of 18. I'm 18 years old now, folks. I was seriously hoping we'd get the festival today because I need a date with Barnaby at this point. Why have we not had it? Anyway, yes, guys, it is my birthday today and now I'm 18 years old. I was, like I said, I was seriously hoping we'd get the festival today. Jam City has been teasing it, but well, I guess Quidditch. Well, good enough. Let's go. We also have a creature side quest, so we have two things today. It's kind of a garbage update, if I'm being honest, but I'm gonna have fun with it anyway. It's my birthday. I'm gonna have fun. So previously on the Quidditch storyline, I seem to remember that we were dealing with part 1 of Sky's Tantrum. Yeah, this is going to be part 2 of Sky's Tantrum. And now I'm thinking to myself, why am I dealing with Sky's Tantrum on my birthday? Why am I not just going on a date with Barnaby? Come on, Jamshedi, when are we gonna get the festival? I'll be in the stands cheering for you when you win the cup. Oh, right, this is the final. This is going to be the final match. And the beater saga. We're not going to get it. This is just going to be part 2 of Sky's Tantrum, I swear. Remember, you're playing for all of Hufflepuff when you're on the pitch. You're a Ravenclaw and you're telling me that. That's actually nice. Everyone's talking about the final. You better be ready to deliver during the final match. I'll try. Guys, I have a bit of a sore throat. So, I haven't done that song I wrote. I did write a song based on the Head Girl side quest, but I did not sing it. I have a bit of a sore throat. I don't want to sound like a cat. So, I will do it at some point. Snahi, got time for a round of wizard chess? I'm not sure if I'm right for it at the moment. I'm still trying to figure out what to do about Sky. And there's a lot of pressure on us to win the Quidditch Cup again for Hufflepuff. The teams for women's have been quite spectacular over the years. You have a reputation to live up to now. Did you know that playing a round of Wizard's Chess has a 58.1% chance of improving abstract thinking? No, it's just going to confuse me further. Can't say I've heard that one before. Oh yeah, for example, a recent opponent of mine was worried about a charms exam, so we played a game. And he started by moving his knight. And then I moved my rook. Okay, it's not Sky he's talking about, so... And then he moved again. And then it went back and forth. But then I moved my queen into place. And then checkmate, I won. I don't get it. So what happened with their exam? They aced it. Oh, that's nice. Like those odds, set the board up. Maybe we'll figure out what to do about Sky while I crush you in a quick match. Yeah, because there is no way I'm winning against you again. I don't understand chess. I don't understand anything about it. The only thing I understand about chess is how the pawns move. I don't understand about any other thing. Oh, by the way, I have been trying to level up my clubs. My Hippogriff and Sphinx club is going very high and my Dragon club is getting very hard neglected. This is okay though. In my canon, Sarahi only joins the Hippogriff club. She doesn't join the others at all. Though I will tell you that Erika is in Dragon club. And Barnaby is supposed to be in Hippogriff club. I don't remember Sphinx club. I honestly don't. I just saw a video on it. My first step to victory is a solid strategy. Okay. Orion told me to listen as much as I can. And you are such an idiot. Honestly. Default MC is such an idiot. You don't know what is the meaning of listen as much as you can. It's the equivalent of MC not knowing the meaning of to move forward you must first look back. I've seen you use that tactic before in a previous game review. Oh, this is the knight telling him. Oh my god. It's a real shame that you're struggling with Sky so close to the final match. Dude, that's not my fault. That's all Sky's fault. I'm not even joking. There are losses in every battle. Oh my god. I don't want to talk about it. Sky and Wrath are rivals that legends are made out of. They're not Pokemon rivals, okay? And even Pokemon rivalries are better than that. I mean, I love Hop, okay? I really do like Hop. And while playing Pokemon Sun and Moon, I really like How too. And checkmate, I win again. Yeah, there is no way I'm winning against you again. Well played, it's tough to see your sneak attacks coming. Being unpredictable is a part of my strategy. I should think of unpredictable ways to handle this quarrel with Sky. Like, dude, she's being so unreasonable. Why do I love her so much? Not a bad place to start. Who can help you easily shake up your thinking? Orion told me to listen as much as possible, but I haven't figured out what that means yet. Idiot.
Hey.
It's not just my birthday. Today is Sarahi Silver's birthday too. Child is 17 now. We totally should have been in year 7 by now, to be fair. That guy has to be the most bewildering Quidditch captain at Hogwarts. You played under his captainship for a few matches now. Do you still trust Orion's unusual methods? Oh yes, definitely. I put a lot of trust in Orion. He's one of the brightest players at Hogwarts. I trust him to make the right calls. I am glad that he has earned your confidence. I mean, he's never led us wrong. This bodes well for the next Quidditch Cup match. But what about Sky? I don't want to risk my partiality as a Quidditch commentator, but I must admit that it is captivating to watch Hufflepuff continue your path to victory. Wow, today I'm reading very nicely. For the last few episodes, my tongue has just not been computed. Flying through adversity, defying challenges left, right and center, creating Quidditch Cup legacy. Hold up, Murphy, we're not there yet. But it might be possible with Orion's guidance. I should go find him now. To be fair, if according to my headcanon, after a quarrel with Sarahi at this age, because according to me, this whole Quidditch capers, they happen between years 2 and 5. So, because Sarahi is very small and doesn't understand toxic friendships at the time, like, she would literally go to Orion like crying, like, what should I do about Sky? I don't want her to be mad at me, etc. Also, when are we gonna get the festival on the page? That's all I'm waiting for, honestly. Dude, I will need time to edit that video. The Quidditch Cup final match is always a wicked game. And if I have class next Friday, I am screwed. Must be a massive rush to play Quidditch here. I wish I was good enough to be on the Hufflepuff Quidditch team. You're a Slytherin. Dude. Won't be long before the whole pitch is packed to the brim for the final match. Dude, is the match today? Like, on the same day? Where is Orion? Oh, there he is. Going for a new record today. Greetings, Sarahi Silvers. I have received word from my teammates that your discussion with Sky and Rath did not go well. That's not my fault, it's Sky's fault, okay? Yeah. These events have left me unbalanced and in search of new answers. You seem rather cheerful though. This estrangement weighs more heavily on my own mind with the Quidditch Cup final rapidly approaching. Dude, trust me, I'm trying here. If you don't mind, I wanted to talk to you about that. I do not mind at all. Perhaps you will be able to find focus by sharing our thoughts. What did you mean when you told me to listen as much as I could? Not all solutions can be captured by searching for them. Sometimes we find them when we wait for their call. I don't get it. Further conflict may only cause us to lose even more focus, making a victory at the final all but impossible. Are you saying that we should just give up on Sky? No, but I shall suggest our next steps in this journey be pointed inward. You're always telling us how important a team's balance is, but what if we can't find it before the final? I have come to the conclusion that we may need to consider the risks involved if that were to take place. How would you feel if we could not resolve the matters with Sky before the Quidditch Cup final? Sky's balance is her business. I worry we won't be able to play our best. We won't be able to win. I worry we won't be able to play our best. We will still compete in the final, but I worry that we won't be playing at our best. Though to be fair, I've been playing friendlies all week, for the clean sweep and all. And Sky is in the match. Usually when we are Sky is like completely missing and she doesn't want to like talk to MC, then she's just not in the match, in the friendly matches. But Sky is there. That means like, she is like keeping the relationship like business, like purely business kind, something like that. I don't know what I'm talking about. Your words carry the bittersweet sting of regret. Oh, come on, my tongue is computed today. Don't let it go off now. Yeah. All that matters is that we do what we can with the time and space we have. If we cannot find balance with Sky at this moment, shall we find balance between the two of us right now? We know, okay? Should I get my broom? Oh, I thought I was joking about the broom, but okay. The final is all anyone can talk about. Our team has grown stronger over the years. Focus can be found in a glance, an instant. It may be brief but powerful. What? What am I doing to make sure to play well during the final? What? And MC, your leg is actually going through your... You never mind. Is it possible? Never mind. I can't read. I would hate for this to distract us during the final match. The final is all anyone can talk about. Listening allows us to ponder words, both spoken and unspoken. Balance requires us to practice stillness. The history of our team shows us how balance creates a path to victory. Okay? If this subject causes disruption, perhaps you should avoid it for the moment. He is basically saying, like, don't run after her. Right? Let me just get the last star and get back.
Hey!
I believe the best course of action is for us to give Sky space during this time. So yeah, he's basically saying, like, don't run after her. Let her come back at her own pace. In the meantime, we should make sure we're ready for the final match no matter what. Agreed. I shall remain hopeful that Sky will regain focus. I just hope that this doesn't end up costing us the Quidditch Cup. Dude, if it did, I will... oh my god, Aurion is sad. That's... So I find it more unfortunate that you look sad, not the fact that that would be quite unfortunate. Hey guys. Penny, Andre, what brings you to the pitch right now? There isn't a match scheduled. I wanted to watch Gryffindor practice for the final. I like to think of it as a preview for the real thing. I'm here to do some research on them. You can never be too careful. You're on the Ravenclaw team, dude. Huh. I heard they're switching up their training methods and I wanted to get a first-hand look. Wait, those are Gryffindors back there? I thought that was Hufflepuff. I haven't seen Gryffindor play since our last match. I wonder how much they've improved since then.
Huh.
Haven't you heard? They started a brand new training routine. Massive upgrades across the board. We were going to watch from the stands for a little while. You should come with us. Oh right, that is Gryffindor. I couldn't tell. I thought that was Hufflepuff. I'll catch up with you when I'm done here.
Hey.
It's okay. It is okay, Sarahi Silvers. Thank you for sharing your views with me today. Go observe our competition with your friends. Be sure to gain some new perspectives on them. Okay. Thanks, Orion. Penny, Andre, wait up. So, say, is it Sky mad at us about being friends with Andre? I mean, Penny is in our house. So, oh my god, it's gonna make me play friendlies, isn't it? Oh my god, that's why I hate Quidditch. Alright folks, I have suffered through the sewage friendlies. Trust me, my game was lagging so much during these friendlies. I don't understand why. My internet is fine. Alright, let's see what Gryffindor's got then. Clara, let's see what you got. She saved a seat for me. Of course we did. Come quick, the Gryffindor practice is about to begin.
Huh.
Look at that, they're taking flight so quickly. Why is one left behind? Wow, it makes you wonder how they're able to fly so fast and keep their formation that tight. It takes a lot of focus and trust. Gryffindor does make it look like a cinch.
Huh.
Thank Gryffindor's new captain for that. She came up with a few new offensive flying formations. Clara, is that you? And those new moves have been quite effective in the Quidditch Cup matches so far. It's kind of cool though. Gryffindor's skills are extraordinary. This is not the same team I played against last time. Hello. They're hungry for a win. Gryffindor hasn't won the cup in years. Their new captain wants to change that. They got something to prove in the final. A lot like you playing as a beater. Maybe, but they don't have the best beater at Hogwarts training them. I appreciate your confidence in my skills, but I'm not the one on the pitch. The final match will be up to you. Are you two here to gab or was the Gryffindor's practice? Dude, what are you talking about? What does gab even mean? Sorry about that, Andre. Now pay close attention, Silvers. They're about to go over their offensive training drills. Dude, let me talk to my friend. Come on. You've never been able to pull that off. You're just as good as Gryffindor's team. Oh my god, Penny, you are not the only one existing. I must say, even their flying formation is quite stylish. I feel so salty about the fact that Penny is the only one existing. Guys, you all saw that new trailer. Why couldn't the game look that good? The game is garbage compared to the animations of that trailer. Hogwarts Mystery shouldn't have been a game. It should just have been a straight up series. Come on. Or it should have been a PC game. If, you know what, if the game could look that pretty, na, I wouldn't even care that it was a paid PC game. See how tightly they took that turn? I did not read that. I'm just saying that if it was a paid PC game if it looked that good. I swear. You'll have to come up with a way to counter that formation. We can't even see them. Come on. This is like at Pokemon Sword and Shield, like critical story is being given in pictures, not even a cutscene for it. That maneuver requires a lot of practice. Though in Pokemon Sword and Shield, animation is actually pretty good. It's just in some areas, it's really bad. Gryffindor has really stepped up their game. No, I don't own Pokemon Sword and Shield. I just did like 10 million videos of it all over YouTube. Because I wanted to play it, but I don't own a Switch. You know how expensive a Switch is? Oh my god. I think the final will be just like this. You've never been able to pull that off. I know. That beta's form shows promise. Okay. I must say that flying. Yes, I know. I just wanted to read Erika's line that I missed. See how tightly they took that turn? You need to be able to do the same. Okay, I've read that line. Now let me just get out. If Sky shows up right now, I call BS. Gryffindor is shaping up to be a competition worthy of the Quidditch Cup. You better be ready to bring your best effort to the final, Silvers. Hufflepuff is going to need it. We've still got time to get it together before the final. I would stay longer, but I must be off to my next class. See you around. Okay, Sky did not come. I don't have to call BS. There is no reason to overthink this. Hufflepuff is the best team at Hogwarts. Don't doubt yourself. They're good, no question. But I'm sure Hufflepuff isn't ready to rest on their laurels until they win the cup. I have no idea what that means. How are you feeling about your chances of beating Gryffindor at the finals, Rahi? I'm not scared of them. Based on what I've seen here, I'm not scared of Gryffindor. Bravery like that is what will help you crush them. I hope. I just hope that bravery pays off on the pitch. I wouldn't count my Quidditch Cups until I've won them. Oh, hello, Madam Hooch. Well, Miss Silvers, I would like to have a word with you in the changing room. Oh God, what did I do? Yes, Madam, right away. Dude, what is this about? Dude, friendlies again? Are you kidding me? Three friends? Oh my god, I hate Quidditch, man. It's my birthday, Jam City. Come on! Alright, Madam Hooch. I did the stupid friendlies. Now please tell me what's wrong. I swear, if Jam City is going to make us do this BS repeatedly, oh, Sky is here, then at least let us skip over the cutscenes. Jam City is lucky I'm a patient person who has high tolerance for such BS. Otherwise, I wouldn't get very far with this game. And yeah, like I said, Sky is here. Oh my god, we are screwed. And I think you're overreacting. We really don't have to do any of this. Madam Mooch is only ensuring that the Quidditch Cup competition remains healthy and fair. What's this all about? Are Sky and I in trouble for squabbling? What? No, that's none of my business. I have brought you here to preemptively head off any mischief around the Quidditch Cup final. Look, in my own headcanon, Sky is also mad. I mean, sorry, Sarahi is also mad at Sky because, how do I explain this in short? Yeah, Sky purposely tried to disorient Sarahi. Sarahi, she lost her necklace in the pitch one time. And after this, between these two chapters. And when Sky did find it, she didn't give it back to Sarahi. She kept it hidden. That made Sarahi eventually found her and got mad at Sky. You know, for that necklace is important to me and you were hiding it from me. Like, how could you do that? Like, headcanon, okay? The last cop had wild rumors circulating about that, resulting in Sky being admitted to the hospital wing. Any foul play or unsportsmanlike conduct during the cup will have disastrous consequences. I'm hungry. I'm so sorry. I'm waiting for breakfast today. Do I make myself clear? Yes, but that's not what I'm worried about. Enough ambiguity. Can someone enlighten me as to what hullabaloo is disturbing the Hufflepuff Quidditch team? Sky is upset with me because I trained with a Quidditch player from another house. That is a gross mischaracterization, you— Hey! I'm just saying it like it is, you dingus! This is not the place to attack each other. We are a team here. If Hufflepuff intends to play as a team in the final, I expect its members to act like it. Perhaps now would be an appropriate time to reassess Hufflepuff's ability to function as a team. Oh dear God. And what do you mean that is a gross misconduct, whatever that word is? That's exactly what you're upset about. Sky, what is wrong with you? Seriously. You're not... This isn't just about training. Of course, that's literally all I did. I've struggled to find a resolution for this. Mischief on the pitch puts every player at risk. It serves us well to remember that we share a love for the game of Quidditch. Okay. We must balance our emotions so that they do not overtake us. I don't think anyone understands what I'm going through. Dude, do you understand what my child is going through? First of all, today is my child's birthday, okay? So, don't do this BS. Just don't, okay? I think we're out of lines already. That was quick. Okay, I'll just speed through this then, I guess. We weren't exactly out of lines. I have made a mistake. I'm so sorry. At the end of the day, I expect everyone participating in the Quidditch to be able to shake hands on the pitch. Especially if they're on the same team. Understood? Yes, Madam Hooch. Yes. I appreciate the message you are sharing with us today, Madam Hooch. Very well. Should this topic require any more discussion? I expect the two of you to work it out with your captain. Okay, now that the lecture is over, can I leave too? I got exams to study for. If that is what you feel you must do, then you may go anytime you like. See you at practice. Aren't you going to talk to her about this? Hooch was pretty serious about it. Sky heard what Madam Hooch had to say. I trust that Sky will come to us when she is ready. While we have this time to converse, I was curious about what you saw at the Gryffindor practice. What is the most important thing you learned from watching this practice? The new captain has something to prove. They've been running speed drills. I think their new captain. Their captain is trying to make a name for themselves. This is their first Quidditch Cup as captain. Interesting. Being eager can lead one to bold triumphs or impatient mistakes. Allow me to express my gratitude, Sarahi Silvers. Those observations required focus to see beyond the surface of training and into its deeper meanings. I mean, Penny told me, that's all. Penny and Andra told me, that's all there is. Penny, Andra and Rath. It shows me that you have grown substantially since you began training with us. Thanks, that means a lot coming from a Quidditch player as skilled as you. Let us go now and take note of these observations during our last practice session before the final. Oh my god, the last one before the final? Sky, dude, seriously, we better get our fight on the hold. I mean, I know it's going to be in the next chapter. Can this thing get out of my face? I mean, the house pet is actually going very impressively. I'm actually winning somehow. I wonder what Orion will put us through for our last practice before the final. Not much time left before the big match. Hope you're ready for it. Hopefully I am. After our race, I'm prepared for anything. Oh, that's nice. Before we begin our Excuse me, I'm so sorry. Before we begin our last practice before the Quidditch Cup final, allow me to share my gratitude for everyone here. Hey. We have worked hard to get here and I am very proud of the progress each of you has made. What's on the schedule for practice today? Another race? At the moment, I feel like we are physically ready for the final, but I want us to be mentally ready as well.
Oh.
Let me add those gawky Gryffindors and I'll show you who's ready. Okay. Hold on to that spirit. We will need it when we face our opponent soon enough. But in light of some reconnaissance that Sarahi Silvers conducted, I want us to have an extra edge. Will we be balancing on our brooms today? That is just one facet of today's training.
Yeah.
A much more paramount element will be looking within ourselves and sharing why we want to win the cup. I suppose that because it would be great to win the Quidditch Cup isn't good enough. I want us to dive deeper and really listen to what our hearts are telling us. Brooms are Hufflepuff. I want us to focus more intensely than ever before. Basically, meditate while standing on one leg while balancing on a broom. That's what he basically wants us to do. I'm fine with it. I'm pretty sure about 20 minutes of this recording has just been like me doing friendlies, which I'll have to cut out while editing. And there's also the matter of the Chinese fireball quest. I would like to see that as a gift for my birthday and Sarahi's birthday. Like, she gets a new creature friend. Got to win. Dad's expecting it. Okay. Oh, by the way, guys, in the data mine, they've also shown us Ethan Park and her father. He's apparently going to be showing up soon. Who knows when, but he will. What would a victory in the cup final mean to you? Like, I've seen his model. So, he'll be showing up. I've got to share before I fall off my broom. At this point, I don't think you will fall off. I think I get it now. Get what? Conquest on the pitch gives me confidence in my studies. Oh, that's nice, man. Winning means we'll be remembered here for years. That's also very nice. That's cute, man. This is my time, my dream. I don't get it. Playing Quidditch has allowed me to see magic in a different light. Oh, okay, this is MC. This is so much harder than it looks. Dad's expecting it, okay. I want to show others that our team is something exceptional. Oh, that's so cute. Okay, what's MC got now? Okay, I think we're out of lines again. Oh my god, yeah. I'll get back in a bit. Okay, I'm done. I see it now. I know why I want to win. I want redemption. What do you want redemption for? You're not rake pick. Okay, that was a bad joke. I'm sorry, I take it back. Why do you think you need redemption? Okay, my question's exactly. Because I didn't get to play in the final last time. Because of what this game means to my family and especially my father. I want to know I played my best and that I played for something. Oh, that's so nice, yaar. Oh. We play our best when the best parts of us play. Hesitations and regrets only lead to losing focus. You have been quite Sarahi Silvers. May I ask you what is driving you in our final match? The love of the sport, house pride, I want to express myself. Oh, I remember this from the data mine. I already picked out my answer. I'll explain once we get it. I want to express myself. This is the answer for Sarahi. Quidditch is how I express myself. By playing well, I am showing everyone who I am and what values are most important to me. It appears you have been listening. So guys, the reason I chose this is because appeals to Sarahi becoming more than a curse breaker. Like, this is what she wanted. Like, when I play Quidditch, I am seen as more than a curse breaker. And I actually feel like a normal student for once. That's what it means to me, like, in this answer. It appears you have been listening. The game means a lot to you. Congratulations, Hufflepuff, we have achieved balance. We are prepared for the final match. Our practice is over. Dude, I'm nervous. Can we talk for a moment, Sarahi? I want to apologize for how I've been behaving. Oh my god, thank god. You were beginning to make me worry. I thought you didn't want to speak to me again. What you said during practice struck a chord with me. I see who you are when we play Quidditch together, and I know you come from a place of caring. Yeah, this is what I wanted. I'm glad that you can see that. It'll be a long time before I can forgive Wrath for taking me out of the last Quidditch Cup final. Hurts to see you be friends with my rival. This is like peak Gloria being friends with Bede and Hop being sad about it, but I think Hop is much cuter. I can't, I won't stop referencing Pokemon Sword and Shield. I really wanted to play that game, man. That's on me and I need to deal with that. But I know we need to work together to beat Gryffindor. Give me a hug now. Can we just call it a truce and let all of this go? No, won't make any promises today. But we can work together to win the final. Give me a hug now. That is the end of the chapter, guys. I swear, even though there are friendlies to do. Yep, there are friendlies to do. Guys, that was the end of the chapter. I remember this last part from the data mine. I'm not even bothering with these. Two Quidditch friendlies right now. Right now, I'm gonna leave the Quidditch pitch. Guys, we've reconciled with Sky. And the next match will be good. Ha! I'm kind of scared. This is chapter what of Quidditch? 11. 12 will be the final. And it will probably also be a TLSQ. So that means it will be next month. Please, we better get the festival next week, man. Okay, guys, now I will now end this video instead of talking for 10 minutes because it's already been recording for 46 minutes. And we shall move on to the second video of the day. The Chinese Fireball Quest. Guys, have a nice day. It's my birthday. I'm gonna have a fun time recording the second video. I was originally going to record a video on Roblox today, but I guess we already have two videos for the day. So guys, have fun, and I'll see you guys in the second upload of today. Bye for now, I guess.